Good day and welcome back. Today we're going to enter a new chapter, which is chapter 17, electromagnetic induction. At the end of this video, you should be able to define what is magnetic flux. And then we're going to learn about Faraday's law and Lenz law and use them to derive the equations of induced EMF in linear conductors and the Planck coils. First is the magnetic flux that we have learned about the flux density in the previous chapter. When we have a coil as shown in this diagram, and we have a magnetic field that passing through the coil at an angle to the normal of the coil, the magnetic flux through one turn coil is defined as the product of the flux density and the area of the conductor that is normal to the magnetic flux. Hence, the magnetic flux through an N turn coil is defined as NBA cos theta, where the theta is the angle between the magnetic field and the normal of the coil. If we have a piece of material with relative permeability mu r in the coil, so there is more flux in the coil, which is defined as mu r NBA cos theta. Next, we're going to learn about the Faraday's law and the Lenz law. Faraday's law is also known as the law of electromagnetic inductions. It states that when there is a change in magnetic flux linked to a conductor, there is an induced EMF in the conductor, which is directly proportional to the rate of change of magnetic flux linkage. While Lenz law is something you have learned in SPM, it provides the directions of the induced current that flows in the direction that produces a magnetic field to oppose the change in the magnetic flux. So from the definitions of the Faraday law, the induced EMF is equal to the rate of change of flux, which is equal to dV dt. While Lenz law states that the induced current is always opposed to the change in the magnetic flux, so we usually combine both of the law, which provide us the equations of the E equal to negative dV dt. So during SPM, we have learned about the story between a solenoid and a moving magnet bar. For example, in this case, when you bring near the magnet bar to the solenoid, so there'll be an induced current in the solenoid that will produce an N pole at the end of solenoid to repel the magnet away. By using the right-hand grid rule, you can obtain the directions of the current as shown in the diagram. In the other way around, when the magnet is pulled away from the solenoid, S pole will be induced at the end of the solenoid to pull back the magnet bar. Now we're going to talk about the first case about the induced EMF in a linear conductors. In STPM physics, you have learned that when you move the conductors to cut through the magnetic flux produced by the permanent magnet, there will be an induced EMF and induced current flowing in the conductors. So in this chapter, we will apply the Fleming right-hand rule that thumbs is referring to the motions of the conductors, and the first finger is representing the directions of the magnetic field, and the second finger is representing the directions of the induced current. You also can obtain the directions of the induced EMF by the cross product of the velocity and the magnetic flux density. Now let us look at the 2D model of this case. When we have a conductor moving through the magnetic field, which is to the right in this case, so the flux constant or the flux linkage is defined as product of magnetic flux density and the area. And the area here would be equal to the length of the conductor multiplied the distance traveled by the conductor. Now we apply both Faraday's law and Lenz law that the induced EMF is equal to negative dV dt. Then we substitute the phi is equal to BLx, and then the dx dt would be equal to the velocity of the conductor. So in the end, the induced EMF is equal to negative BLx. So the negative signs is compliant with the Lenz law. So we would usually always add it in the derivations, but when you are considering about the magnitude of the induced EMF, we could just ignore the negative signs and obtain the magnitude of the EMF is equal to BLV. Next, we're going to talk more about the change in the energy. So there's a force applied on the conductor to move through a certain distance, and that is work done. So the work done is converted into the electrical energy, which is the induced EMF and the induced current in the conductor. So substitute the formula of the work done and the electrical energy, where we have the equations of Fx is equal to Bit. And then we can substitute the formula of the voltage is equal to BLV, rearrange the equations, and we could obtain that Vt is equal to x. So in the end, the force applied is equal to ILV. So in the previous chapter, we have learned about the magnetic force that apply on the conductor due to the magnetic field. When there is an induced current in the conductor is also subjected to the magnetic force due to the magnetic field. This time, we would apply the Fleming left-hand rule to obtain the directions of the magnetic force. which you would get the directions to the left in this case. Since the force applied to move the conductor is equal to ILB, that is equal to the formula that we have derived in the previous chapter, so we can conclude that both the force and the magnetic force are having the same magnitude, so there will be resultant force acting on the conductor in the magnetic field. Hence, the conductor will not accelerate but moving in a constant velocity in this case. Next, we're going to talk about the second case, which is the induced EMF in the Planck coil. So you also learn about something called the generator in STPM physics. One is the DC generator that uses a split ring commutator, and another is the AC generator that uses the split ring to produce the AC current. The difference between these two generators is the type of the ring, which I have mentioned, and also the types of the output, either DC or AC current. Now let us start to derive the induced EMF of a rotating coil in the magnetic field. So the coil will be rotated in a circular motion between two permanent magnets. So the rotation speed or the angular velocity is defined as omega equal to theta divided by t. With this, we can define the magnetic flux linkage is equal to nba cos theta, and then we can substitute the angle with omega t. So the flux linkage is equal to nba cos omega t. Now we're going to use again the Faraday's law and the Lenz law, where the E is equal to negative dv dt. And then we have the E is equal to negative nba multiplied the derivative of cos omega t. So we have E is equal to nba omega sine omega t. And then we could simplify the equations as E equal to E naught sine omega t, where the E naught is the amplitude or the maximum value of the sine graph. Now we're going to interpret the equations here. First, let us talk about the AC voltage. So based on the equations, we can draw the graph response of the induced EMF against the angle, where the amplitude of the graph is equal to nba omega. When the angle is equal to 0 degree, that is when the coil is perpendicular to the directions of the magnetic field. So we could see the directions of the motion of the coil is parallel to the magnetic field, based on the cross product of the V and B. So we can conclude that there is zero induced EMF in this case. Next is when the angle is equal to 90 degrees. So the coil now is perpendicular to the directions of the magnetic field, and the motion of the coil is perpendicular to the direction of the magnetic field. So based on the cross product of the V and B, the induced EMF will be the maximum, which is equal to E naught equal to nba omega. Last but not least, the DC generator produces a DC voltage that the equations is almost similar as what we have derived, except that the value of the induced EMF is always positive all the time. So the graph response is as shown in this diagram, and the equations you could derive as the modulus of the E naught sine omega t. So that's all for my discussion today. More exercise will be discussed in future. If you have any questions, you can leave it in the comment section below. Also, do leave a like, share my video, and subscribe my channel. I'll see you in my next video. Thank you.